A friend to all, an enemy to none. That's how Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has been describing his foreign policy since assuming office. But in the face of China's continuing aggression in Philippine waters and his pivot to the U.S., can such stand hold? Pia Gutierrez with the special report.
It was a red carpet welcome with full military honors for President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. last May 4 when he visited the Pentagon. An honor which, according to Malacanang, was the first time to be given to a visiting head of state under the Biden administration. In the closed-door meeting that followed, U.S. Defense Chief Lloyd Austin assured the Philippine leader of the United States' support in the South China Sea.
So make no mistake, Mr. President, we will always have your back in the South China Sea or elsewhere in the region.
The same assurance also given by U.S. President Joe Biden to Marcos Jr. in their landmark meeting in the White House a few days prior.
The United States also remains ironclad in our commitment to the defense of the Philippines, including the South China Sea, and we're going to continue to support the Philippines' military modernization goals.
Philippine Coast Guard Vessel, PRP Malapascua.
For the Philippines, these statements hold much importance given China's growing aggressiveness in the West Philippine Sea. In fact, just days before flying to Washington, D.C., Philippine and Chinese Coast Guard ships almost collided at the Yungin Shoal after the Chinese exhibited dangerous maneuvers and blocked the BRP Malapascua, which was on a resupply mission in the disputed waters. Several weeks prior, many countries condemned the Chinese Coast Guard's use of a military-grade laser against a Philippine Coast Guard vessel, temporarily blinding its Filipino crew. Amid rising tensions in the West Philippine Sea as well as the Taiwan Strait, the Philippines and the United States held its biggest ever military exercises last April. Almost 18,000 Filipino and American soldiers participated in the annual Balikatan, or shoulder-to-shoulder exercise, with the aim of enhancing military cooperation. Washington and Manila also signed the bilateral defense guidelines, which included, among others, plans to modernize the Philippines' defense capabilities. All of these happening within a year into Marcos's term in office.
He was able to reestablish a stronger relationship, one that is based on mutual respect for each other.
Marcos's efforts to revitalize relations with the United States stands in stark contrast with the foreign policy of his predecessor, Rodrigo Duterte, who sought closer ties with China.
The only way that you could really have a leverage on the Chinese is if you have a closer security relations with the United States.
But some analysts doubt how far Marcos's pivot towards the United States will go, as the Philippine leader is clearly not turning his back on China, which is also the country's largest trading partner. Marcos Jr. visited Beijing in January, where he met with Chinese President Xi Jinping.
He is trying to strike a balance between U.S. and China. He is advancing security ties and cooperation with the United States, but at the same time, he is different from former President Aquino III because he's not completely shutting the door on China's face either.
The president himself has said, despite existing challenges, disengaging with China is not an option for the Philippines.
We have not shifted away from China in any way whatsoever. As to the differences between China and the Philippines, it is something that we will continue to work to resolve.
In fact, Manila and Beijing want to establish a direct communication line to manage tensions in the West Philippine Sea.
Hindi tayo naghahanap ng away. Naghahanap tayo ng solusyon.
Despite these efforts, incidents in the West Philippine Sea persist. But Marcos Jr. claims the situation there has improved. Aside from the West Philippine Sea issue, the Marcos administration has also taken a cautious approach on the issue of Taiwan to avoid being caught in a conflict over the self-ruled island, which Beijing still claims as part of its territory. In May, Marcos Jr. assured that he will not allow the Philippines to be a staging post for any foreign power, even after the Philippines allowed the U.S. increased access to its military bases under the Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement. Four additional EDCA sites were designated, three of which are located in the northern part of Luzon. International Studies Professor René De Castro explains Marcos Jr.'s balancing act.
It's basically our survival mode. That's the only way we could survive this very dangerous situation. Because, you know, we have to understand we cannot control everything out there, given our limited capabilities and given the fact that, of course, our economy is tied to these great powers.
Moving forward, De Castro says it is important for the Philippines to further strengthen its domestic economy and the capabilities of its military.
President Marcos Jr. has said that the Philippines is located in a region that has the most complicated geopolitical situation in the world. That is why, as he winds down his first year in office, it remains a challenge for his administration to ensure that despite its limited capabilities, the Philippines is still able to navigate the many challenges in the region while making sure to uphold and defend its sovereignty. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.